Here's how you can solve this problem in 1 minute. So we have car number 2, and it's trying to catch up to car number 1. Now, car number 2 is accelerating, but car number 1 is not, meaning car 2 eventually is going to end up on car 1, or in the same place, basically. Now, notice that it has to travel a total distance that the car 1 travels plus the 50-meter deficit. So the only thing we need to calculate this problem is this equation right here. We just need to plug all our variables from car 2 and all our variables from car 1. So let's start with car number 2. Car number 2, we're going to use all these variables we see, and we're going to plug in this for our delta x. If we do this, we should get this equation simplified down into simplest terms from here to here. Now, we'll take car 1 and also plug it into this equation, and we should get this expression simplified down as well. So now we have a system of equations where we can take our car 1 equation and plug it into car 2 where we see d. That's going to give us this equation simplified down, will give us this quadratic. You can use algebra to simplify this. You should end up at this quadratic here. From here, you can use the quadratic formula, and you can get your two answers for t. Although having a negative time doesn't really make sense, so we're going to stick with the 6.35 seconds, and that is how much time it's going to take for car 2 to catch up to car 1.